So here's the stomach, here's the cardiac sphincter, and here's the pyloric sphincter. So here's the lesser curvature, and here's the greater curvature, okay? And here's the fundus. If you open the stomach up, you can really see that it has these little striations called rugae, which help churn the food right in here. And again, this is the cardiac sphincter. And so food will sit in here for about 30 minutes to a few hours, depending on the individual. But after you start eating, you go to a buffet, sometimes it takes anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes for your body to say, okay, I'm full. You can do some damage at a buffet at 20, 30 minutes, so you have to be careful. Also, because of the shape of this, if you're going to take a nap after eating, which you shouldn't do, but try to sleep on your left side so the food kind of stays right here. If you sleep on your right side, then the food can kind of come up and back up and you can get a little bit of a heartburn or indigestion here. Okay. And then the food will leave out the pyloric sphincter right here. So if you've ever had a drink on an empty stomach, what happens is the pyloric sphincter is usually open, so the alcohol will come in here and rush right into the small intestine. But if you have food that's sitting in your stomach, then what happens is it's harder for the alcohol to pass by because the pyloric sphincter is closed and it's only allowing a certain amount of food to pass by. So that's the difference about drinking on an empty stomach versus a full stomach. It's how close the pyloric sphincter is. Okay.